Hi, welcome to Enchiridion. Pharyngolepis was a jawless fish that seems to have been intermediate in its development towards a more open water lifestyle, like the Thelodus, which was a jawless fish with much better swimming adaptations that lived in the same time as Pharyngolepis. Pharyngolepis was most probably a poor swimmer due to the fact that it lacked basic key stabilizing fins. It had a pair of bony spines that projected from the pectoral area, and a row of crested scales that ran along its back. There was a well-developed anal fin, and the tail was downturned, yet none of these features would have stabilized its deep body. It only had a pair of spines and a series of low-crested scales that ran down its back instead of a dorsal fin, meaning that it couldn't swim for extended periods or at high speeds, due to the fact that without pectoral fins to act as hydroplanes to stabilize pitch, Pharyngolepis would eventually just nosedive towards the bottom. Due to this, Pharyngolepis was probably a slow swimmer that stayed close to the seafloor, where it searched for small marine organisms. It probably fed by scooping up tiny food particles from the bottom sediment. It was named by Kier in 1911. It belongs to the kingdom Animalia, with the phylum being Chordata, the class being Anaspida, the order being Burkiniforms, the family Pharyngolepidae, and the genus Pharyngolepis. Species include the type Pharyngolepis oblonga, and other species like Pharyngolepis heinzi and Kieri. Its diet is uncertain. It was around 4 inches or 10 centimeters long. It has been found in Norway, Europe. It lived during the late Silurian, roughly 443.8 to 419.2 million years ago, and few specimens represent Pharyngolepis. Thank you for watching the last program episode of Jawless Fishes or Prehistoric Beasts. I plan to switch to more notable prehistoric creatures and leave the obscure ones like Pharyngolepis to a later time. As always, this is Enchiridion. See you next time.